Good afternoon, Colorado. Welcome to Tuesday edition of What's for Lunch. I'm your host, Larry Hurst, and today I have my old, long-time friend, Frank Bonanno, here from Salt and Grinder.
We're friends?
Well, yeah, we've known each other a long time. How about that?
Too long to admit.
Two grizzled old veterans. One person got out, one person still in.
Oh, still in. They keep pulling me back.
Pull you back in. Give the people at home who don't know who you are your history.
So I'm Frank Bonanno. I'm a chef, restaurateur here in Denver. We have 11 concepts. We have Denver Milk Market, with Mizuno, our high-end restaurant, Luca, Osteria, Cocktail Bar, Green Russell, Dive Bar, Vesper Lounge.
Can you name them all?
Lou's, Hot and Naked, Salt and Grinder, which we're here to talk about today.
Did you get Osteria?
I said Osteria. See, the Long Island guy can't even pronounce the Italian name, which
the
is
Jersey
perfect.
Guy thinks he knows.
Yeah. But yeah, those are some of our concepts, and Milk Market is on 18th and Wazee and has 16 mm-hmm. concepts in it. So it's a lot.
And your first restaurant, Mizuno, opened in what year?
In 2000.
A 20-year anniversary?
20-year anniversary was in the middle of COVID, March 27th.
Did you do anything?
Yeah, we had dinner at my house because we were closed. So, no, we really haven't done anything for it, so we're thinking about what we're going to do for our 21-year anniversary, when everyone can drink.
21's a good number.
Yeah.
Give us the concept of Salt and Grinder, and where it is and what it is.
So Salt and Grinder's in the Highlands. It was really, this restaurant came about through necessity. So I was curing all my own Coppa and Soppressata, Prosciutto, all those Italian cured meats, and the health department apparently didn't agree with how I was doing it. So I needed a vehicle or a space to really do it legit. And there was a deli that had been on there. I live like a block away. So there was a deli right there that had gone out of business like every 4 years or 3 years. So I was like, we should just take this and I'll just make this a curing room. The rent was cheap. And for what we do in cured meats between Luca and Osteria and, you know, how much we were doing and using, it just made sense, and then it gave us like a legitimate facility. So I wrote a HACCP plan and got the city to approve it and everything, and then Jacqueline, my wife, was like, we can't have an empty storefront on our block, a block away from our house. That would be terrible. And I was like, I don't really want to do anything there. I just want to do the cured meats. Uh-huh. And she was like, no, you have to do something. So we were like, a deli, a New Jersey deli. I mean, you know, not a fancy deli, more of like the bodega style sandwiches that I grew up with, where you went to the meat market or you went to Wawa's and you just got really good Hoboken bread with boar's head meat and what have you, and you ate a great sandwich, and it was reasonable.
Which, oddly enough, there really isn't anything like that
around. No, so that's why it made sense to me to do it. Really just doing something that I love and something that I like. And when my kids and I would go back to New Jersey, which we still have a house in New Jersey, so going back there, and we would always just go down to the deli or whatever to get a sandwich. And so it made sense, right? We're curing all this meat and stuff. We were already making fresh mozz at the restaurants and making burrata and making ricotta. So like, let's just do a nice East Coast style deli out of Salt and Grinder. It's small. I mean, it's like 600 square feet. But it has a big basement, which is where the curing room is. So it just made sense. I got approved by the city and state to do my own salumi program. So hence Salt and Grinder was born.
And what year was it born?
God, I want to say that was 8 years ago, seven years ago. And it all runs together when you're our age. I don't know what to tell you.
Believe me, I know.
I can't remember what I did last Thursday. So.
No. But I really don't remember what you had for breakfast. Whose bread are you using?
We are using City Bakery, Michael Gortz.
Like Michael.
So
it's
when
the best baguettes in town.
When we were originally opening up, you know, we went to a couple bakers and we were like, I literally was mailing him frozen sandwich rolls from New Jersey. Like, I'd buy them, freeze them, and send them to him and be like, this is what I want. And so he was like, yeah, I think I can do that. And so eventually he got as close as I can get. They're a little more dense than what you get from like Hoboken, New Jersey, but it's pretty
it's close.
Damn close. So
close. That's what I use at my restaurant and for making cheesesteaks.
Yeah, he's really been a great partner to work with. Yeah.
It's crazy, but
all bakers are crazy. You know, during the shutdown, we started making a lot of our own bread. So the Salt and Grinder at Milk Market is now making their own bread. I had a lot of time on my hands those first 2 months of the shutdown there with a lot of ovens at my disposal. So I started working on the dough recipe, but the volume we're doing at Salt and Grinder, it's just easier to have Michael do the bread.
Let's talk about what you brought today for lunch.
So I brought two of our most popular sandwiches. One is the Frankie, which is...
Is it this one?
Yep. And that's our house-cured copa, ham, lettuce, arugula, and some of our burrata spread on top with a red wine vinaigrette.
Yes, please.
There's some prosciutto on there as well. Yeah. And the other is the Italian beef, which is probably more of a Chicago thing than it is a New Jersey thing, but it's really popular. So it's our rare roast beef with jardinière, provolone, iceberg lettuce, tomatoes, and you know, the jardinière is the star in that.
I'm assuming you're making your own jardinière.
Yeah, so it's just, you know, that's one that morphed, that the Chef Mario that's there was like, you know, this is so popular. We were doing the Italian dip one that they do in Chicago, like Portillo's.
Yeah, I like that.
But that was not popular at all. This one has been twice as popular cold without the dip. So
let's talk about sides.
Sides, straightforward sides, like a German potato salad. That's our coleslaw, just simple, like a mayonnaise based. Gotta have macaroni salad. And then the most popular side, quite honestly, is the orzo, arugula, and parmesan. Number one side, no question about it, with a red wine vinaigrette.
I've never seen this before.
But I think it's like my spin on them. It is my spin on like a macaroni salad, except I'm trying to make it appear healthy, whether it is or not. It's plenty of parmesan cheese on there, but super simple. You know, we do have cocktails and some booze there, but for the most part, our business is sandwiches to go.
Are you doing meatball, hot sandwiches?
We do chicken parm, meatball parm, eggplant parm, but I didn't, those wouldn't travel very well. But our bread and butter, no pun intended, is our cold sandwiches. That's what people come in for. So super simple.
What's the exact address? 32nd and what?
32nd and Lowell, right next to Mondo Vino. I wish I knew the exact address.
I'm not going to ask you the phone number. Forget about that. How about the website?
It's saltandgrinder.denver.com.
All right. And what are your hours?
We are open Tuesday through Sunday. Okay. We open from 11 to about 7 on Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursdays. Fridays and Saturdays we open at 11 and we go till 8.
Do you do any breakfast sandwiches?
We do French toast. We have like a little brunch on Saturdays and Sundays. So there's some egg sandwiches and stuff. Those we opened with egg sandwiches, like on Kaiser Roll. Not very popular. So there are certain things I realized, like that I grew up eating that I freaking love, that it may be so indigenous to just New Jersey.
I eat a breakfast sandwich every day before
like
school.
Like we were doing Taylor ham and egg sandwiches. Yeah. You would have thought I was slicing liver and putting it on the sandwich. People were like, I don't know what that is. I want bacon. So, you know, you have to change and morph to what the people know. And then you get the true New Jersey, New York, tri-state people that come in and like, how come you don't have Taylor ham and egg? Because you didn't come in every day and order it. You came in once every 2 months and we can't buy it just for you. So we occasionally do it. But for the most part, you know, that's what I've learned about things. Like one of my favorite sandwiches, we still have it on the menu, is like turkey, American, lettuce, tomato, salt and pepper. Like that's the New Jersey staple when you go. And that's like the biggest dog. But we threw avocado on it and put like Swiss cheese on it. That sells out the door.
And you put avocado on anything.
Yeah, in New Jersey though, they'd beat your head in. I don't know where that came from, because that certainly isn't me.
We didn't grow up eating avocados.
No, and I go back quite a bit, and they still don't
eat.
No, you don't. That's like putting pineapple on a pizza.
Couldn't agree with him more.
Or chicken on a pizza. That just doesn't happen.
That's not as bad as pineapple.
It depends. Okay. Depends who you're talking. If you're talking to me, I think it's as bad. But we're in a different region of the country, so you've got to adapt, right? You got to give the people what they want, so to speak.
So you don't have any pineapple at Osteria?
Osteria.
If you did, would you allow somebody to put it on?
No, and actually I have yelled at servers who put chicken on pizza there too, like threatened to fire them. So they do it when they know I'm not around.
Do you use for Salt and Grinder delivery?
We don't. It's just all Uber Eats, DoorDash, okay, and then curbside pickup.
But you prefer they don't use those and come get it themselves.
You know, that's...
You'll take whatever you can get, I know. But.
We'll take what we can get. You know, everyone's bashing those guys right now.
You're not bashing them?
It is what it is. Right? I mean, you live in the world, the cards you're dealt,
yeah,
so
you don't
to
have
speak.
To,
so,
you as a business, you don't have to sign up with them.
Yeah, you don't. So I don't feel like you can bash somebody just because they're trying to make a buck.
My point is, to the public may not know.
For the public, yes. They take a tremendous share of what the purchase is.
So if possible, get off your couch and go
get it. But guilty as charged, I order Uber Eats all the time.
You do not.
Yes, I do.
I've never used it in my life.
You're a better man than I am.
No,
I can't tell you. It's on my kid's phone. He's hungry, and he's like, "What should we have for dinner?" And I've just gotten home at 8 o'clock, and it's like,
well, that's because you work so much. I got a nice easy gig, so I.
Yeah, so I mean, I think it's just convenience. I mean, that's part of it. I mean, yeah, I prefer everyone order and come and pick up, but yeah, do as I say, not as I do. I guess, right? I don't know what you know. But it is better for the restaurants, and they are gouging us tremendously to get it, but we are grateful for a sale.
Some people don't know, so it's just important.
Yeah, they gouge the...
They gouge the crap.
Crap, you can't say that.
I can't say crap? I can say shit.
Oh, come on, man.
So tomorrow we'll have another Frank restaurant here. We'll have Lou's. Right?
Yeah, Lou's Food Bar is coming. Lou's Hot and Naked is in the Milk Market. Lou's Food Bar is on 7th and Grand.
So we're going to have some fried chicken sandwiches.
Yeah, Nashville hot chicken sandwiches. And it's awesome. And, you know, that was one of our restaurants that closed, but it closed because I sold the real estate. So they made me an offer I couldn't refuse on the real estate.
Really got the reference.
So, so that was it. But we always knew we wanted to do it again. So when we opened Milk Market, we did Lou's Hot and Naked. And then that is really popular there. So we wanted to do a little spin-off of it. So we did Lou's Food Bar, which is attached to Vesper. And you can actually walk between them. And we just added a big gelato case. So now we're serving gelato there. So I'll have Omar.
But he's not coming back tomorrow.
If I can come back tomorrow, I'll come back tomorrow.
That'll be amazing. We'll see you tomorrow for Lou's on What's for Lunch. And I'm going to have this sandwich. Let's eat. Oh, yeah. Real deal.